nous vous offrons tout.
Politique, économie, culture, sport, musique, nous vous offrons tout.
Nous vous offrons tout.
Sur Royal FM 88.4, faites-nous confiance.
Faites-nous confiance.
Baby, let's go. Écoutez Royal FM, la radio des auditeurs.
Auditeurs, auditeurs.
Ensemble, oui, la main dans la main.
Jamane Bessa Emmanuel Noël, Joja Majin, Bata Bichema, Bata Ululuma Chengu, Namibia Mwaye Kumbu, Mangayangane Cameroun, Le Kalumanga Lenge, Linene Ye Kumbu, Cameroun, Ukumbu Yaha, Ebelansang, Nsangabe Mwaye Kumbu, Idin. Ebe ate abon biye kumbo. Na lulume akonbe hengo. Anyul bonvanane. Bukwarbe awelan. Bukwarbe amunduru. Bukwarbe aliye. Ne ye kumbo. Ebe e kumbo. Ye burbobise. Benga keli yivanane. Ele e kumbo. Ye lulume.
Ensemble, main dans la main pour préserver l'unité de notre cher et beau pays, le Cameroun.
C'est un message de Royal FM, la radio des auditeurs.
It is Monday, July the 5th, 2021. It is the 186th day of the year, 179 days remaining until the end of the year 2021. Good morning, good people. Welcome to Royal Morning News, coming to you from Royal 88.4 FM. In our late story this morning, Communication Minister warns publishers for non-respect of the law when it comes to the deposit of copies of their newspaper. How did newspaper stakeholders receive this news?
It produced a lot of fear as far as the communication landscape of the country is concerned, because
get this and more in this edition. And still in this newscast is for the head coach of Atlas in action, cry foul over the selection of Atlas to represent the country in the Olympic Games. This and more right ahead. Good morning once again. My name is Abel Bela Samari. We open our news to tell you that the Minister of State Property, Sylvia Lantino, and a panel of ministers will today meet with members of the National Assembly in a bid to enlighten them and address their concern during a special plenary sitting at 10 a.m. Meantime, the 2021 to 2024 budget orientation document has been tabled at the National Assembly in a plenary sitting Sunday and chaired by House Speaker Honorable Kavai Yegejibre. The document has been sent to the Finance and Budget Committee for examination, and on Tuesday, July the 6th, 2021, a plenary sitting will take place to debate on the document that will be defended by the Minister of Finance, Louis-Paul Motazé. Like I said in our leaked story, the Minister of Communication, René Emmanuel Sadi, has called on newspaper owners to respect the law by depositing two copies of their newspaper each time they publish. Minister René Emmanuel Sadi, in his press release issued on Friday, July the 2nd, 2021, said it has been noticed that publishers no longer respect this procedure. I spoke with some newspaper stakeholders, beginning with Amos Musang and Etienne Menjo, to find out if their newspaper outlets actually respect this procedure of dropping two copies of their newspapers.
The post has been depositing newspapers at the Ministry of Communication now for some time now, because the law states that print media are supposed to be depositing their newspapers at the Ministry of Communication. The post has been doing that because I am the one that is always going and depositing it. It poses a lot of fear as far as the communication landscape of the country is concerned, because at this present moment, government wants to see how to regulate what the media is writing. As you bear with me too, that the media can cause an uprising, and government is doing everything possible. And given the fact that equally that newspapers have become and very easy to create, with anybody just working one morning and creating a newspaper. Mm-hmm. So it's very important for the government to see how to put that But notwithstanding, government equally has to understand that there is press freedom and that government has to respect that.
I have been doing that. I've been depositing the two copies as they always request. That's two copies per edition. So I've been doing that since the first edition of my newspaper. No, I don't think it infringes into the rights of publishers because that's what the regulations, Cameroon regulations concerning communications, private communications to police. And I think that we're supposed just to abide to the minister's decision. It's not in any way infringing into our rights as publishers, to my own understanding.
The first copies of the biometric passport has been handed over to some Cameroonians in less than 48 hours by the Delegate General for National Security, Matemba Gangele, in a ceremony that took place in Yaoundé on Friday. In hand to witness the handing over was the Minister of External Relations, Lojen Belambela, who had this to say.
The same system has been put in place by the government. The problem will only arise when we have to collect the passport and to send them back to our compatriots who are abroad. But we are going to discuss this issue with the Director General and the General Delegate of National Security. Even in the diplomatic missions, there shouldn't be no problem. But it will take a bit of time because some diplomatic missions are very far. When you take the example of Brazil or Moscow, you see the delay will be a little bit longer. But the system has been put in place everywhere.
Honorable Alioum Fadil is the first person to have received this new biometric passport.
This morning I received a mail telling me that my passport is ready to come get it in this afternoon. Having been there, my surprise was even greater to see the authorities, the minister in charge of external relations and the Delegate General of National Security being themselves here and giving me the first biometric passport of Cameroon.
You are listening to Royal Morning News coming to you from Royal 88.4 FM. We talk education in this newscast to say the Cameroon GC board has sent its 10 warning to those leaking out examination questions on the ongoing 2021 General Certificate of Education exam session. That is, if caught, they will face the wrath of the law. The institution has also refuted information that Paper 2 Advanced Level Biology has been cancelled and will be rewritten on July the 10th. It should be noted that the GCE exam entered the second week today with countless rumors of examination leakage and other malpractices. We stay in education to say the government of Cameroon has summoned 600 absentee secondary school teachers across the country, with over 300 from the crisis hit Northwest and Southwest regions. According to a release from the Minister of Secondary Education, Professor Naluva Lyonga, the 600 teachers have been declared absent and might be out of the country. The release equally indicates the names, the great matriculation number, schools where the concerned teachers were assigned, and continue where possible they might be residing at this point in time. And out of the 600 teachers, the Northwest region has 264, while the Central region follows suit with 106, closely followed by the Southwest region. The East region is last on the classification table with just 7 teachers that are missing. And on to this human interest story, a class 6 teacher by name Ke Pascal in the town of Bafoussam is behind bars for allegedly rape a 9-year-old pupil. According to the parents of this little girl called Steffi, their child reported the rape case to them, and immediately they rushed her to the hospital where a medical report confirmed that her virginity has been tampered with. The Bafoussam Dilang Foot Gendarmerie Brigade, after their investigation, caught Nge Pascal, the class 6 teacher, trying to assault another people. It should be noted that the said teacher is a father of 2. And we take you out of the country to say supporters of South African ex-president Jacob Zuma has formed what they say is a human shield outside his residence to try to prevent him from being arrested. On Tuesday, the Constitutional Court found him guilty of contempt of defying its order to appear before the before the court in a corruption case, and he was slammed 15 months in prison. We talk sport to say that the head coach of the Athletes in Action, an athletic club under the Cameroon Athletic Federation, Coach Chamaki, has decried the injustice in the selection of athletes to represent Cameroon in the Olympic Games. According to the coach, the Cameroon Athletic Federation deliberately refused to send qualifying results of their athlete Raphael Ngale, who picked up his qualification on March the 7th, 2021 in Yaoundé. Take a listen to the coach.
Thank you very much for your concern about this matter. Because it has been 2 days that we were really touched about the final decision, the final news that we got from the Olympic Committee. Mm-hmm. You know, I actually qualified that day because the entering standard for the 200 meters was 20.24, and Afaya accomplished 20.09, which for a long period of time was among the best performance in the world. I know the Federation actually needs to send the results, the technical results, and make the observation about that. So for a number of reasons, I will name them so that we should be brief on the phone. The first reason is that the Federation was delayed in sending the result because I was actually the one running after them. And during that period of time, they told me the way they recorded down the results was not actually adequate or did not match with the way they were expecting. So it stayed for long. And finally, the AJ showed me a mail proving that he had sent it. A very long period of time, that's what happened first.
And it is from that note in sports that we wrap up this edition of our 6 a.m. newscast. More newscasts will be yours at 8 a.m. in the French language, 12 news in the French language, 2 p.m. in the English language, and 6 p.m. is going to be a bilingual version. The team keeping you company this morning is made up of Carver Production, which is our copyright clerk. Solomon Isana is our sound engineer. Lenkwe Kama, DJ editor on our Facebook page, Raya FM Cameroon. The news was produced by Mbeng Emmanuel with editorial coaching coming from Jean-Patient Tala. Coordination was done by On Station Manager Bertrand Nwuna. General supervision was done by Reverend Pastor Emmanuel Nwebesai. For presentation, my name is Abel Bela Samari. And joining me in the studio is Bill The Rock. Good morning to you, Bill.
Ah, bonjour, Abel. Mon Dieu, quel plaisir. Eh ben, dis donc, il faut dire que, bon, ben, en fait, tous les matins, maintenant, je suis un homme aguerri.
Ah bon?
Oui, parce qu'à tes côtés, bon, ben, en fait, il faut avoir du punch.
Bill The Rock is here with Royal Martina. Bill, what are we going to be having?